time now for our Passion to Profit series, celebrating young people making their mark on the business world. So this morning, we have two young women who are turning their beauty and fashion creativity into the companies of their dreams. Meet Maddy Maxey and Emily Weiss, two CEOs rising to the top of their industry. Maddy, a creative technologist with an eye for fashion, bringing smart fabrics out of the lab and straight to the runway, capturing the attention of one of Hollywood stars, Lupita Nyong'o. The dress, coded by Maddy, designed by Zach Posen, thanks to Google's Made with Code program.
We work on electronic textiles, prototyping. We also work on research and development to find better ways to manufacture e-textiles.
Maddy dropped out of Parsons to start her own company.
The Created started out kind of as this fashion tech lab.
Her parents approved only one semester off. That was 3 years ago. Maddy's latest project, this lightweight jacket she calls Kelvin, created with thermochromic fabric.
You can see that it's getting really hot here, and that's why the fabric is changing color.
Illuminating examples of the future of fashion. Following her passion in 2010, Emily Weiss left her job at Vogue to focus on her beauty blog, Into the Gloss.
I really like to just have like five things.
Her top shelf posts sharing the beauty secrets of some of the world's most recognizable women.
There's a lot of products out there, and as a beauty editor myself, I've tried a lot of them.
Inspired by her discoveries, in 2014, Emily went from writing about beauty products to creating her own, launching a direct-to-consumer line called
Welcome to Glossier.
We really wanted to take the guesswork out of beauty by pre-curating a really easy-to-use, universal, and modern range of products.
The digital world recently came to life at this New York pop-up shop.
There's not a one-size-fits-all shape to beauty anymore. Individuality is key, and we have always perpetuated that here. This notion that you should really be proud of who you are every day.
And we are proud of them. Emily Weiss of Glossier and Maddy Maxey of The Created are here along with top fashion designer Rebecca Minkoff. Thank you all. Aren't you just inspired by what you're seeing here?
Beyond inspired.
Oh goodness. Okay, so Emily, you are online, but you have these pop-up stores because you like to connect with people, don't you?
Yes, I do. It's really important for us as a digitally native beauty company to connect with our customers in real life. Mm-hmm. And a lot of beauty stores can be a little overwhelming, a little crowded, you know, perhaps a little bit messy. And for us, we really wanted to create an offline experience where girls can come together and hang out and share tips with each other and get to know one another in addition to trying on our products.
I love this mini pop-up store that we have here.
Thank you.
Just kind of give people the example. So congratulations.
Yeah,
this is
so
wonderful,
much.
And I can talk
thank
more
you.
To you about it. Come on now. I mean, your fashion is cutting edge, and we have some wonderful models here. Grace is wearing, tell us a little bit about what she's wearing.
Absolutely.
Here, Grace.
Absolutely. Grace is wearing a series of garments that we designed that respond to sunlight,
mm-hmm.
and they're all STEM concepts. So we were trying to take this new twist on wearable tech of using new materials, but also using programming languages to make the graphics that you see on the garments.
Wonderful. And we saw this in the piece. Come on up, Zach. Come on up. Let us see. That's the, what's the
Yeah, so Kelvin is a heated jacket. Our idea is that you should be able to wear one of like Rebecca Minkoff's beautiful leather jackets and have it keep you warm.
Uh-huh.
I think that by now that sort of thing is totally possible.
And we saw this, Misha, you gonna step on up? We saw this on Lupita. Tell us about that creation.
Absolutely. Yeah, so this project, it's been such a pleasure to work with the Made with Code team because the problem that we are really looking at is that a lot of girls don't think technology is creative
mm-hmm.
and it doesn't relate to the things that they love. So we let girls program the animations on this dress, showing them that code isn't just a web app, but it's also the things around us.
That's
everywhere.
It. Oh, we have a special message. Somebody wanted to give you a little shout out. Take a look.
Ooh.
Maddy, thank you so much for the design you made with Zach Posen. I thoroughly enjoyed wearing the dress. It lit up my night.
Mm-hmm.
Oh,
so how do you
gosh.
Feel about that?
That's such an honor. Like, Lupita doesn't know who I am.
She does now.
She does now. Wow,
and we know who you are, Emily. What, tell us about, I mean, for you, you're at Vogue, right? You're
yes.
at Vogue.
Yeah.
You give that up. You know, a lot of people want to have that courage. I mean, where did that come from that you knew that you could take that risk?
I think for me, it was a fairly easy decision because looking at the market as a beauty editor, you know, I saw a lot of brands out there that were really focused on red carpet looks or runway looks, when in fact, you know, it's 8:30 in the morning and most of us are going to work or, you know, going to school. And so we really wanted to create a very modern company that celebrates beauty in real life. Mm-hmm. And for us, what that means is creating a range of products that live with you, not on you, are really universal, are really easy, and are really meant to make you look your best and not try and become someone else. And for us, it's been really exciting, and it made the decision sort of easy to be very mission-driven in that way.
I love that, but I'm just looking, I know like you are too, Rebecca, going, because you came to New York at 18.
I did.
And you said, I'm gonna take it by storm, and you have absolutely do that. And it's about taking risk, and you said you have to know what type of risk to take, perhaps?
I think you have to be smart about the risk you're taking. Okay. I think as an entrepreneur, it's sort of built into, you know, that in itself, that you have to be a risk taker. But we wouldn't be here today if I had not talked to my customer. That was a risk, believe it or not, back in the day, or talking to influencers or using technology to be more in touch with my consumer. Those were all risks, but they, you know, built the brand to what it is today.
And how do you break out? Because there's so much out there in fashion and design. And so how do you make your mark?
I think it's about finding the white space within the white space. It's about evolving. It's about being in touch with your consumer. It's about using technology like Emily and Maddy have done to really talk to her more and talk to her more often in the way that she wants to be listened to.
And how would you both talk to people who are watching, some young people who want to do what you're doing or have their dream?
Absolutely. I would say stay curious, keep asking questions and gain all the skills you can, because regardless of whether things succeed or fail, if you've learned a lot along the way, then it's really valuable.
I like that. Ask questions. And for you, Emily, what do you say?
I would echo Maddy and say, you know what you don't know. For us, that was a lot, and that can be a humbling realization, but I think it really gives you an opportunity to learn from people who, you know, who have been there and done that and be open-minded.
I'm putting that on a t-shirt. Know what you don't know. I can work with you both on that.
Perfect. Let's do it.
Thank you. And Rebecca, congratulations
thank
on
you.
All that you're doing. And thank you for the advice that you give as well. So we thank you all. And the way you can turn passion into profit, but the way it is, the spirit and the heart, that's what it's all about. Thank you all very much.